Sub-Zero, King of the Dot, Volume 3. Calgary, please make some noise. I am your host, Sketch Menace. I just got a beer from my co-host.
What up, it's Ddubb. You can hit me up at Ddubb at kingofthedot.com if you want to get into Ground Zero. Shout out to all the sponsors. Check out their labels at the beginning of the videos. And subscribe to youtube.com/groundzerobattles. All that being said,
we're about to get into the heavyweight championship match between none other than rapper to my right.
I also say yo.
Forkfarm,
Black November. Fork Smash!
Yes! Rapper to the left, introduce yourself.
Yo, it's Nekkbone. AKA the Chief of the Dot. AKA the Creator. AKA that big dude that harassed you for change at the bus stop. Shout out, Eastside Magic. Kaz Mega, SOB, let's do this, buddy.
Yeah. You guys just you're from farther away. You're from farther away, call him here.
Coin toss.
Been harassing.
It is heads.
After you, sir.
90 seconds.
60 seconds. 60 seconds.
Go.
I'm pumped. It's going to be a sick battle.
King of the Dot, Ground Zero, Volume 3. Please make some noise for this before this battle pops. It's on Nekkbone.
Yo, I'm gonna need you to focus. Stand straight and pay attention. If y'all got any questions, at the moment I'm giving a lesson on how to play calm. Our winter showcase aggression. We'll even touch on cheating techniques for STD testing. Now comprehension must be considered a blessing, for we understand that good times manifest from bad intentions. And I must mention that my intent, well, it's initiated to increase and inflict tension. Now see me, I'm a heat seeker with a demeanor that's meaner than either Mussolini, Joseph Stalin, or even Julius Caesar. Put a bitch in front of me and I'll beat her. Like a rape victim, I'll treat her. And you do that, you intimidate her, you penetrate her, and I'll be supplying the ether. I fucking love white people. I fucking love white people, but I hate big dickheads with small cocks. And if you ever have sex and then a child, kidnapped, wrapped in a blanket with smallpox. God, I hate this hairy fucker. He's confusing us in. If I scalp him, what I remove? The top of his head or his chin? I slice his chin off to the bone. His mouth feels abandoned and alone. I put that piece of chin to a set of nuts, well, it'll feel right at home. It's like a fucking handicap in a fight. Nekkbone versus Forkfarm. Like Lennox Lewis versus a warhound fucking swinging with short arms. Now, I'm a fat motherfucker, but this dude's a fat faggot bitch. This guy's so old, he makes DVS look like a fucking Cabbage Patch Kid. And I'm gonna end this by saying, your mom's a loose cunt bitch. But I've got a pretty big dick, so my shit just fits.
Wow.
Let's go.
I have serious reservations about making any native jokes. So I'll play it close. Ahoy there, matey. Wait, please. Say he's Apache thinker. You won't get the double meaning. Cause he know his breath reeking. The problem is I'm dealing a shovel to your brains and fill your grave till you stop breathing. All I'm saying is this Micmac needs a Tic Tac. And new legislation should be passed that will allow him to take a shower. We won't laugh when he asks. Oh. Native supremacist, eh?
You fucking hate Columbus Day! And fucking hate the Hudson's Bay!
I heard they made a show about you that airs Thursdays at 8, and that's great, man. I'm sure it's fucking lovely, but no, I haven't seen Everybody Loves Rain Dance. I got that cute piece, your wifey, big whitey, she like ye, I promise. Slip of that Mickey, she see Minnie after I poke her harness. No Disney, I'm G-rated, Polly want that cracker, no parent. Take shots from that cannon, split your wigwam, no haircut. Beating you is what it do. It's in my nature, boy, so lick my nuts. Right after the pause for this Ric Flair strut. Now go fuck off in your canoe!
Time. Round two, Nekkbone.
You ever talk about Pocahontas again, I will squaw slap you with my big palm. And do you like I did City, fuck you in the ass and make you clean out my wigwam. See, I am one of the elite in this division. I am a motherfucking beast. And all homo intended, I chew up MC's assholes with my teeth. I take MC's dipped in bacon grease and I have me a feast. And to say the least, that's why the chief is so fucking obese. Speaking of obesity, I asked this guy what he wanted to bet for this battle. He told me let's bet a McDeal meal. Then explained for Halloween he's gonna shave his beard and go as Rita McNeil. I said after the battle, let's grab a bike. I'll buy you one of those infamous Calgary donairs. He said, thanks for the offer, bro, I'm stuffed. I just gobbled a fistful of bone airs. You've never faced an MC like me. See, I'm gritty and grimy. I got some rugged Indians behind me. And if I'm riding, they riding. I'm entertaining with the rhyming. Been to jail and done time, B. Built up a reputation of fucking grown men in their hiney. I heard some of your tracks. You try to play it off like you're deranged and you're twisted. When really the only sickening thing you ever did was finger fuck a baby kitten. And then for weeks, you walked around with your head high and your chest out. See, his friends talked about pussy on their fingers and Forkfarm felt left out. Now, I'm the deranged one. I'm twisted. Y'all fucking know you believe that. The other day, I fucked your great, great grandma. And I yelled at her, bitch, can you feel that? And I'm stroking and I'm waiting for an answer. But the hoe never screamed back. And then it just hit me. Oh yeah, I'm a fucking necrophiliac. For a decomposed old slut, she knew how to spread spunk. But the irony of the whole story, I gotta say she's a dead fuck.
Have the swagger of a female statue in a fountain. How the fuck am I gay, dude? You and your people discovered and then named Brokeback Mountain. You spit so much garbage in here, I'm surprised you don't turn around and shed a single tear. I ride my G37 at all times because I'm official. Pull out that iPhone, beep, and your brains will paint your Pinto. And when I enforce, I dot your car with Dabalingo and Hiroshima your corner in my B-29. Bingo! That's the only joke I have about native zoning casinos. Here's the only bar I have about that fucking Canadian tuxedo. A lot of devil. But what's ironic, Pops? My favorite team in the NHL is the Chicago Blackhawks. They say your whole scene died the day Fork put the blaze to his neck bone, case closed. A laser beam cross-creased from Taser to Kanan would light you up, but stick shorts, Patrick Sharp, Overshot, Kanopka, Duncan Keith, reversing feet and Siebes already in retreat. This gon' be a tall chore, but I deny any palm thrust that turns into an odd rush. Semin to Knubel, back to Semin to Ovechkin when I stomp bars screaming out, Lord, he's proper, and I kick slide, stick slide, like I'm Corey Crawford! Tomahawk your face off and show you what's fresh though! The grinder lines are out, we're putting elbows in the neck bones! Let me sketch this out for you. All my bars are coded, just in case you didn't notice. It's so cops will never know it's your obituary quoted. But this call get dropped like the switch was overloaded. In the morning, all they know is Farley Mowat's car exploded.
Sketch, if he'd have took off my hat, he'd have been in serious trouble. Speaking of Brokeback Mountain, weren't you a butt double? Yo, I want just 1 minute with the camera, okay? If any native rapper ever disputes this, I'm in the fucking Alberta division, manic. Check this out.
Shit!
I claim to be the wickedest indigenous to spit this shit here with viciousness. Coinciding with the ambitiousness, I spit venom like it's syphilis. This dude's a victim of a relationship. He got played by loving. His old lady broke it off and said, Chris, we should just stay cousins. On the real, check this out. This is what I think about you. You're a fucking loser. You're pathetic. You're retarded and creepy. Dude said Drew Barrymore looked her hottest when she was starring in E.T. Forkfarm is actually a fan of mine. On Facebook, he messages me all the time. Says I got a presence that can't be shined and I'm pretty funny with the rhymes. This guy's trying his best to be like me so much, he wants the Eskimos to win the Grey Cup and tells me that he's so pro-native, he's straight up Team Jacob. This old fucking bearded cocksucker learned to live in the now. Like when we first met, I went to shake hands and he looked at me and said, how? How what, you dumb motherfucker?
That's what you said.
I was upset with this clown. I kind of stood there with a frown and realized it's not his fault. His father has a syndrome known as Down. My real Indian name literally translates to dances with wolves. This guy's mom was a stripper. They called her dances with poles. This guy's mom was an overweight stripper. Some called her dances with rolls. I just call him like I see him. She's a fat, scandalous hoe.
Yeah.
Drinking Canindian. Your whole life, your parents knew you were a cocksucker. Apparently, you had issues. As a pre-teenage boy, he'd jack off in a handful of Kleenex, and then he'd gobble the tissue. I'm gonna be a bitter Indian if I lose this battle. You will witness me turn into manic, and I'll smack around Forkfarm like he's my wife after she went Bern to Bannock. And when you sing songs and make them your own, you fucking suck. I know it's scary but true. You and Cheddar Shee should fall in love and start a fucking parody crew. Time.
Round three, four.
fucking Brokeback Mountain. That punchline was pitiful. No, that punchline was just unaboriginal. The rest of this round is entitled, Thank You for the Cigarettes, You're Welcome for the Firewater. You're welcome for the cigarettes. Oh, sorry. Thank you for the cigarettes. You're welcome for the fire water. Sorry about the residential schools. Enjoy your culture on our dollars. Thank you. That's only the first four bars. Shit.
Love it.
Thank you for lacrosse, that wonderful contribution to sport. But we gave you Jerome Ginla, you only gave us Rennie Bork. And if we're being truly honest, even Bone can admit, you owe the world an apology for Alanis Morissette. Thank you for naming the skunk. Fuck you for smelling like one. You may say, I want to thank you for the tip on birch bark and the acetylsalicylic acid. I say you're welcome for the healthcare despite the lack of paying taxes. My friend said I shouldn't use that joke in case you get a medicine man to curse me. I said, cool story, bro, but these pretzels are making me thirsty. So you can get as pissed off as you want, believe what you want to believe. It's not my fault your ancestors traded Long Island for some beads. And if we're being real, and this is a real one, son, those blankets with the smallpox were only meant to be tough love. How were the pilgrims supposed to know that your people weren't immune? In the same breath? Yeah. How the fuck were they supposed to do something about it with their scalps removed? The obvious lesson. The next time a group of white men appear on your shores, steal all their food and beat them to death with their oars. Otherwise, it's just as much their fault as it is yours. Yeah.
King of the Dot, Ground Zero, Calgary, Volume 3. We'll be right back with the judge's decision. Calgary makes the noise! Welcome back to Ground Zero, King of the Dot, Volume 3. Calgary, if you thought that was a hot battle, please make some noise. Say for myself that I was excited for this one. Before I announce the decision, how tall are you and how much do you weigh?
6'4", 280.
Woo. And Nekkbone?
6'4", 170.
That's the last time I ever go first when people tell me that.
Heavyweight championship shit for Ground Zero Division. Again, before I announce anything, that was an amazing performance from both of you. Please make some noise for the battle. To both these guys for coming out, Forkfarm all the way from Burlington, Nekkbone from
the Res.
Way out there. The winner by a 4-1 decision, Forkfarm.
Shout out to everyone back in Toronto. Check out www.blknov.com. Pick up some of my music. And if you ever need to get a t-shirt done, www.comegetcustomized.com.
This guy's fucking crazy.
Big shout out to Nekkbone.
Yo, it's Daly. I thought this guy right here didn't win. I gave it to my man Forkfarm. I thought both guys coming into this had crazy presence and energy, and I knew it was going to be a battle like that where they could control the crowd with even average lines, but I felt like this was an instance where, you know, they both had that going for them, but Forkfarm has the pen game to go with the presence, and a lot of people don't give him that credit, but the dude is a good writer and a good rapper, where I think Nekkbone honestly has to work on that aspect of it. I think he's kind of one-dimensional. He leans on the mom jokes, and him being native kind of has limited angles where maybe Fork did attack the race aspect, but he rode his bars really well. The reservations, the shit he said, even his setups were absolutely hilarious, and he's a hard guy to beat, man. Like, I heard Chron just beat him, so shout out to Chron, even though he's a little faggot, but... Forkfarm all day. I thought I was a body bag. Shout out King of the Dot. Shout out cameraman, my boy Overbite. White man wins the game.
Yo, what up? It's Overbite, man. I'm host. I'm not hosting anymore, but I'm judging. I'm doing my thing. Nekkbone and Forkfarm, sick. Both of them have crazy presence. Both of them command an audience. If people going wild in this motherfucker right now, smashing walls and everything. I gave it. To Forkfarm, honestly. I thought that Forkfarm's creativity with his all three rounds were amazing. Nekkbone, he had great lines here and there, but he wasn't really controlling the crowd as much as I thought he would against Forkfarm. I have to give an honorable mention to Nekkbone. Nekkbone is one of the sickest MCs out here in Alberta. Forkfarm took a definite win here, but Nekkbone is somebody to reckon with, man. You watch out for him, man. Nekkbone gonna be killing it later. Peace, over by here.
Yo, what's good? It's Theory. Placement shout-outs to King of the Ddubb, Calgary. A year ago today, we were posted up at Sal's on 17th. Fucking zombies walking around. Probably like 100 people maybe in the event. Look at us now. We're at a ground zero, pushing bigger crowds than I've seen at lots of events, period. Big battle, Forkfarm and Nekkbone. These dudes are, it's a heavyweight battle to say the least, you know what I mean? Nekkbone came out strong, I mean he had good lines, but I found when Forkfarm came out with all the different branches of native jokes, I found that he just gripped that first round and he ran with it from there. I mean, Nekkbone did his thing though. I mean, every verse of this battle was top notch, but I found at the end of the day, Forkfarm basically broke him down on a more personal level. Nekkbone tried to go out and just try to address some other things, and I found that just Forkfarm basically addressed him a little harder than Nekkbone did, and I gave Forkfarm the win on this one. Theory, battling Stevie P out in Vancouver December 3rd, sorry. EP coming out December 7th, check it. Theory, Blazing, the King of the Dot, we through here.
What's up? It's L-Rev. I'm at King of the Dot, Ground Zero Volume 3, Calgary. Sick event, really, really sick headlining battle. I judged the headlining battle. I was the lone judge who voted for Nekkbone. I thought the first round, Nekkbone just slightly edged it. He had a couple really hard-hitting lines. A lot of people gave him a lot of reaction. He had to shut up during some of his lines. Forkfarm's theatrics are off the hook though. Like, the dude can act. He's really a well-rounded rapper. Like, he's a very well-rounded MC, so I'm not taking nothing from him. That first round was really close. Second round, I gave to Forkfarm. I think that was a landslide for Forkfarm. I don't know, it was just a couple of his lines that really stuck out to me, and it was just like super, super sick delivery. Like I said, the theatrics of it really took it for me. He definitely outperformed Nekkbone in that round. Third round, slight edge to Nekkbone. He had huge crowd reaction. His presence was huge. He's louder, he's bigger, he's just got, you know, a little bit more command of the crowd. So I gave it to him overall. Nekkbone in 2-1.
Forkfarm, Black November, enjoying a tall, frosty bottle of Canadian. It's a crazy beer they have out here. Just battled Nekkbone. Dude is crazy. He's absolutely crazy, and no one should ever sleep on this man. He stays like right behind me, so it was a good battle. The flips I came up with in the heat of the moment worked well, and it was just hype, and I'm glad people realized the tongue-in-cheek kind of nature of my third round, which could have been taken really racist if it wasn't done kind of like John Cleese in the Dead Parrot sketch. We're still friends. The crazy thing is, Nekkbone told me afterwards that his cousin, he's cousins with Rene Bork, which made that Rene Bork line even better. So, shoutouts to Sketch for having me out here. Shoutouts to Nekkbone for not beating the shit out of me, for making fun of him. And he's bought me like more beer than any person in Toronto has ever bought me. Thank you very much. Okay, I'm done.
Yo, it's Nekkbone. I'm taking this shit up with Indian Affairs, Aboriginal Rights. No, I'm just fucking with you. And I said cousin-in-laws. I'm in. Give me a minute, babe. That's my girl right there. That's my old lady. She's my old lady. But we're also first cousins, you know? You guys would call that incest, but on the reserve, we just call that pure breeding, you know? I'm fucking with you. Someone's gonna use that in a battle, right?
Right? Probably.
Someone's gonna use that in a battle. But anyways, okay, check this out. On a real, cousin-in-laws, Rennie Burke, straight up, homie man, fucking number 17, Calgary Flames, you do it. Forkfarm, great opponent. This was my third battle in all of KOTD.
Dope.
And we were the main event, and it's my first L. But, this motherfucker can kill it. This homie can kill it right here. So, I just want to say, me and Forkfarm, good friends, pound of bread.
Right here.
Good friends. Aboriginal people out there watching this, please don't get offended. It's a battle. If this dude was any other heritage, because I don't know what he is.
I'm British. I'm not Jewish. I'm British.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, well, no, I mean, that's it.
I apologize for your Britishness. I apologize for his Britishness. But anyways, it's a battle. It's a battle. That's just how shit goes all the time. Fucking, my fans, from now on, my fans, you watch Forkfarm.
Yeah, same here. If you like what I do, you love what this man does.
Yes.
And quite frankly, like, if anybody is offended by anything anyone says, you realize that he made jokes about fucking my dead
grandma. Hey, shut the fuck up, this is my interview. Okay?
Sorry, man. It's shut always like a white man.
Fucking guys, like, just taking. First they take our land,
then they take
give us more pie, and they want our interviews now. Anyways, respect. KOTD, you'll see us again, you will see me again, you will definitely see him again. Never know. 2-on-2?
Yeah, let's do 2-on-2.
2-on-2, tag team partners.
Let's
right
go.
Here.
Let's
fucking,
go.
Fucking earthquake and what's that? Typhoon, motherfuckers.
Yeah, natural disasters.
Let's go. Peace out. We got it. Yeah.